Hello, fellow book nerds! My name is Scarlett Cole, and I'm here to talk about my debut novel, Mercury Rises, and how it came from idea to fruition. So before I get started, I want to thank Jean for having me on the blog today. I really appreciate the exposure. As a debut author, sometimes it's hard to get your name out there, so I really appreciate it. And to everyone out there, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy the story. Anyhow, as I said, I have a debut novel that came out February 13th from Inkspell Publishing, and it was called Mercury Rises, and it looks a little bit like this. Anyhow, as you can tell on the cover, we have some arrows here and the green hood, and a lot of people, when they see the arrows and the green hood, the first thing they think is Robin Hood. And if you do that, you would be correct. This is a retelling of Robin Hood. However, I've taken a little bit of a different spin on it. This is a YA novel, so it is a YA near futuristic retelling of Robin Hood from the point of view of a rebellious Maid Marian named Mercury Masters. And you can see Mercury on the front. So just a little bit of a different spin. It does have romance. It has government conspiracy. It has a virus that is killing off half of the population. So a lot of different dynamics at play here. However, this isn't exactly how the story started out. Originally, what I was doing is I wanted to tell a retelling of Robin Hood that was a cute contemporary romance, something fun and light. It was actually something that would be a cross between Mean Girls and Gossip Girl and The Duff. So if you were a fan of any of those, I'm sorry, I didn't write that book. It was in June, and I had some time coming up where my family was away, and it wasn't busy at work, and I had beta readers reading my first novel that I completed, Wicked Descent. Wicked Descent actually doesn't come out till March 2nd from Ever 19. However, if you do like YA Paranormal, you should check that one out. It's a fantastic story, but that's another vlog. Anyhow, I had some beta readers working on that, and I really wanted to throw myself into a new project. I'd been working on something called Sleepless, and it had kind of stalled out a little bit, so I really wanted to start something new, start something fresh, and so I came up with this idea of doing this Robin Hood retelling, and I wasn't exactly sure how I was going to do it, and then I came up with this contemporary romance concept. And it was very cute, and it was very fun, and I was working on plotting it, but it really wasn't my, it isn't something I'd done before. I typically had been in that paranormal, fantasy, horror realm, so it was something very, very different for me, I was working on plotting it, putting all the pieces together. I'm definitely a plotter, not a pantser. And everything was kind of falling into place. I was liking the story. I was liking the characters. And then one day I went for a walk downtown. At the time I worked in downtown Winnipeg, and there was this old rundown hotel that I passed on my walk, and I'd seen it 100 times. But this particular day, a scene started developing in my head, and there was this girl and this hotel in the middle of nowhere, and these other characters started coming in, and it all just kind of started whirling around. So I got back to my office and I sat down and I just fired off a bunch of words. And most of that is what became the first chapter of Mercury Rises. And when I took a look at this girl, I thought, well, she's not my cute contemporary romance heroine that I was looking for. So I figured this would just be a completely other project. Anyways, I continued on working on this project, and this first scene just kept coming back to me and kept coming back to me, and I just really wanted to do something with it. So my brain started working on, well, what if that was my Maid Marian? What if this cute contemporary wasn't what I was meant to write? So I went back to this original scene and I started working with it and tinkering with it, and it started building and building and building and building and building. And the virus concept was something I had come up with a long, long, long time ago. I just had no idea of how I was going to work with it. It seemed a lot more political thriller type thing, which really wasn't something I was interested in writing, but I managed to kind of merge those two concepts as I was working through the story, and it ended up really, really complementing each other, which was fantastic. And so at that point I decided, why couldn't it be paranormal? Everything I wrote was paranormal or horror or had some sort of that aspect to it. So I was really, really worried about this book not having that same fantasy type concept to it. So I tried to every which way that I could to put a paranormal spin on it, and I went, that's not this book. So now I was sitting here with these pieces of a book that wasn't what I intended to write, wasn't what I typically wrote, but it still had this fantastic core of characters that I absolutely, absolutely adored. So I decided, you know what? I'm going to let this book just be itself and write it and see what happens. Anyways, I managed to finish the book, and it was definitely completely different than what I originally had. And it's a lot harder to write human beings that don't have paranormal concepts, because at least when you get stuck with that, you can just insert a monster. But I couldn't do that here. So it was definitely a challenge for me, which was great. And it was a lot of fun to write because it was something so different and so new from what I normally did. Anyway, so this cute little contemporary worked its way into this sort of dark, dystopian romance with a whole government subplot, and I really hope you enjoy it. So it's called Mercury Rises. It's come out from Inkspell Publishing, and thanks.